Okay, well, the show just finished. That was pretty incredible. King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard at the Regency Ballroom in San Francisco tonight, billed as a rave set, and that is exactly what we got. Now, if you were watching them this summer and saw the live shows, you saw the table. That's exactly what it was, which is what we expected, and it was, in fact, the Silver Chord played in its entirety, in order in its entirety. Again, I suppose was expected. We did get a bonus song, an Intrasport bonus there at the end. And did it just at maybe the first two songs was they were taking their time getting into it because they were okay, but nothing extra special. In fact, I started wondering if I was going to make it all the way through here over in the on the Eastern time zone. But starting with set all the way through, your set got the place bouncing. Of course, it was going to. And it just went above and beyond. And then, and sometimes when they're playing it live, like I know that Petro is the companion album, which doesn't make any sense, but somehow it is. And then you hear it. I think it was a Change in Witchcraft, I believe, were the two that it was just like you could hear it. And then there at the end was Stu coming, like just as you feel like you're feeling flamethrower. Stu starts saying flamethrower, and I don't know why it is live. It happened in Chicago too to me. It like you could just hear it. So cool when that happens. That's pretty cool, man. And I maybe that set may have been the best. Maybe Swan Song. I don't know. Extinction, perhaps. It was pretty amazing. If you enjoyed the table jams this summer and, you will like this one, I would say, this whole show. I wasn't sure if they would be able to carry 2 hours of it. I wasn't sure if I would be into 2 hours of it. Like an acoustic show, I can handle some of it. I like some of it. Some of it I really like, but I just don't know if I'm into 2+ hours of it. This, in fact, I could stomach 2 hours of it and enjoyed it and was really wanting more there. I was thinking, oh, they debuted Intrasport. Maybe that was just a practice run for tonight. They debuted Interior People. Maybe that was just a practice run. Maybe we're gonna get that. And then sadly, we're not. We're getting bullioned. I'm not sticking around for that. Although this show will get a re-listen. So I don't know. That's about all I had to say. The set list was the album, the Silver Chord, in order. And it just seemed like they kept picking up as they were going. I don't know. That final 90 minutes was just completely just blazing. All right, man. Blaze on. Ambi. What's up with Ambi's arm? What did Ambi do to his arm? I'm unaware. He had some kind of brace slash bandage or something on it. Calves looked like he was tied onto a nice one. What was calves on? I do not know. Did not affect his playing at all. Still machine calves back there, but. All right, so that's about all I got, I don't know. I don't think I said much of anything other than it was outstanding. They are, in fact, wizards. Each one of them's a wizard. Maybe not Cookie. I don't know. We'll see. Sorry, Craig. They're all okay. Even Cookie's a wizard. All right, if I must. But collectively, there was certainly some wizardry at work tonight. Wizardry. Wizardry. Wombat, wombat, wombat. Boom, we're out of here. Thank you. Boom. Good night. Good gizzin'.